extraordinaire, ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Ian Bateman. And a motley crew on the saxophones. We have the from all the way from Germany, ladies and gentlemen, Matthias Seufert. On the lead alto, Mr. Robert Fowler. And I cannot remember the other guy's name at all. He does look familiar to me. Yes, it is.
Winston
Churchill. Winston. No, it's not Winston. Although there is a little likeness. Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Alan Bunn. And no stranger to you, ladies and gentlemen, Thomas Spatz Langham. Malcolm Scared at the sousaphone and double bass. And Mr. Nick Ward at the grand jazz percussion kit. Now we're going to give you the West End Blues. Great favourite, Louis Armstrong, but this time with the vocal by Miss Joan Viskant.
Thank you.
Winston from Ashton. On a rainy Tuesday in 1930, the great black orchestra of Noble Sissle was actually in London, and they came to miserable place, Hayes in Middlesex, to make a recording. And they were playing better than ever, Noble Sissle. And I've chosen one of the numbers, and it's a number about salvation. Quite religious piece called You Can't Get to Heaven That Way, you see. So we want lots of people shouting out, hey brother, praise be, have mercy. What other things can we shout out? Hallelujah, hallelujah brother, yeah man, okay. Bit of clapping on the offbeat, all right. So right, Noble Sissle in his orchestra, You Can't Get to Heaven That Way, and You Sinners Be Damned.
One, two, five.
Sunday, raise the devil on Monday. I got one gal, two gals, another gal on Wednesday. Howdy, boys. Oh, now, you like me, like I like you. We gonna see the light. I want your arms and I want your lips and I'm on and every night. Come on, let's cuddle. Come on, shout hallelujah. You got shoes. Now when I get to heaven, gonna rhyme with the shoes.
Can't get to heaven that way.
Now I've got a robe, you got a robe. All got shit and got robes. When I get to heaven, gonna wear that robe. Oh, I've got a song, you got a song.
All got shit and got song.
Now when I'm in heaven, gonna sing that song. Oh, I got wings, you got wings. When I get to heaven on the side of the wing, don't get to heaven that way. I can't get to heaven that way.
No!
Can't get to heaven that way. Go to Hades. Really getting us a bit het up, actually. I think I have to slow the tempo down because of our pacemakers within the orchestra. And we'd like to ask Joan back to sing a lovely song from the 1930s this time. And it was recorded by Benny Goodman, wasn't it? Were you with Goodman at the time, Joan?
I was with Batman.
Oh. Well, you have to explain that kind of thing. Ladies and gentlemen, you turn the tables on me. Here we go.
One, two, one, two, three, four.
for me more. But now that you're gone, I'd welcome anything from the 5 and 10 cents.
Vic Spiderbeck was in the orchestra of Paul Whiteman in the late 20s, but he'd made a series of records with the Frankie Trumbauer Orchestra, and they were so successful that when the Whiteman Orchestra went on tour, Whiteman got absolutely mobbed by people wanting these particular tunes that were done by a much smaller band. So he got his arranger, Bill Challis, to transcribe the Vic recordings, and so they could play them with the fuller orchestra. And we're going to do one of them now. It's called Singing the Blues, and it is not the Tommy Steele hit of 1957 that I know you do prefer, but and it has a great saxophone section, which is not on the original record. Are you still awake, Barnes? Just right, anyway. Poor buddy. Yes.
You have not missed the
okay. Ladies and gentlemen, singing with one, two, three, four. I'm going to finish this first set with a number that was originally played by the Ben Pollack Orchestra. Now, Ben Pollack had a star-studded band in Chicago in the late 1920s. On clarinet was Benny Goodman. For a while, the trombonist was Glenn Miller, Jimmy McPartland, and, well, Ben Pollack sang himself, didn't he, Spats? Tell us about Ben Pollack's singing.
Ben Pollack's singing was, he was a bit smarmy.
I'll say.
He was a little bit smarmy, and there is some film of him singing, actually, and he moves his arms like this and does all of this kind of stuff like that. He really is a bit smarmy, really. He's like a used car salesman, actually. And I can say that because my brother's a used car salesman, and he's extremely smarmy.
What was his catchphrase at the end of every record?
May it please you, Ben Pollack.
Anyway, who's going to be Benny Goodman?
Me, I'm afraid.
Oh my God. At least be safe.
Thank you.